Katie here, and today we are going to talk about dry fasting. So if you've been following me on Facebook, you know that I'm a huge fan of fasting, and we do five-day fasts in my Resetter tribe. If you are not a part of my Resetter tribe and you want to be in there, just put Resetter in the comments. I'll invite you in. But here's why I love fasting, is that your body is a miracle. Your body knows how to heal. The thing is that we were never taught strategies on how to tap into this healing. So in my Resetter tribe, we do a lot of different types of fasting. We do intermittent fasting, and we do fast mimicking. We do water fasting. So we do dinner-to-dinner fasting. But there is a new fast that is emerging and gaining a lot of attention, and it's called dry fasting. And let me tell you, before you wonder, like, you know, as you put those two words together, like, what is dry, what does fasting mean? Before you start to like click off of this video, let me kind of walk through what we know about dry fasting and why it could possibly be the quickest way for you to heal your body. So for starters, dry fasting, it's just like it sounds. You're not doing any food or any water for a given period of time. Now, as that sounds crazy, I want you to stop and think about this for a moment. There are a lot of religions that are very skilled at dry fasting. So for example, the Muslim religion on Ramadan, they do from sun up to sundown, they do no food and no water. And they've been doing that for centuries during this holy time. So other religions do the same thing. Fasting is pretty much built into almost every religion for cleansing reasons, for discipline reasons, for spiritual reasons. So fasting is more safe, it's easier than you've been probably led to believe. I think with dry fasting, what I hear from a lot of people is, don't you get thirsty? Isn't it unsafe? How long can you go without water? So as I started to look at the research, I launched into a dry fast experiment for myself. So I dry fast for the last four Mondays. I've been dry fasting anywhere from 12 to 24 hours. With dry fasting, I'm gonna go through the benefits here in a moment, that you wanna go for a shorter period of time, which is pretty cool because you're getting the same benefits as a water fast, but you're getting it on a dry in a shorter period of time, not removing water from the equation. So the first thing to know is that it's for a shorter period of time and that it can actually have a deeper effect. So for these past four Mondays, I've been experimenting with it. First Monday, I woke up in the morning, I had a glass of water and a little bit of coffee, and then I didn't do any food or water until the next morning. The last thing that went into my mouth was at 6 a.m. I didn't do anything until 6 a.m. the next day. I have a good friend who does a lot of fasting. She did a lunch-to-lunch dry fast. She had ate and drank up until lunch. Then starting at lunch, she didn't do any water or food until lunch the next day. So it's a 24-hour period, no food, no water. So first Monday, not that hard. It's pretty easy. Second Monday, I had a really busy Monday, a lot of things going on, and I only made it about 12 hours until I felt like, oh my God, I got to drink, I got to eat. There was like an innate feeling inside of me, so I listened to my body and I started to eat. Third Monday, 24 hours, no problem. Today's my fourth Monday, and I'm going to go 12 hours today. It was just a decision I made. So with dry fasting, you go for a shorter period of time. Now, let me tell you what happens in this short period of time. So you guys that are insulin resistant, dry fasting could possibly be the best way to kick yourself out of insulin resistance. So when you remove water from the equation, the body starts to go searching for areas where there is water. And there's water in your fat cells. So it's going to start to metabolize that fat so that you can get that water. That's why dry fasting is so cool for insulin resistance. So I would say number one reason to do it is to kick yourself out of an insulin resistant state. Second thing, those of you that are patients of mine or resetters and you've been obsessing on your blood sugar level, because it will kick you out of this insulin resistant state, it's a really proven path for lowering blood sugar. So anybody pre-diabetic, any of you that are really working really hard to lower blood sugar, dry fasting can be great. Okay. Second thing, a lot of you ketogenic lifestyle people, if you've been following the ketogenic lifestyle and all of a sudden you go and you meander into your doctor's office and your LDLs are through the roof, your total cholesterol is through the roof, guess what? Dry fasting has been known to balance out cholesterol levels. So better than water fasting, better than any other type of fasting. So if your cholesterol's high, you've tried everything, look at doing a 12 to 24 hour water fast. Okay, those of you in pain, if you have chronic issues, so if you've watched any of my videos, I talk a lot about how I healed an Achilles tendon injury with a water fast. Well, guess what? With dry fasting, what we're seeing is that your inflammatory markers come down. So your body stops producing this chronic inflammation that's causing part of the pain. If you've gone into your doctor's office and your CRP levels are really high, guess what? Dry fasting has proven to bring those chronic CRP levels down. So for inflammation, it's fantastic. BDNF. BDNF is like a growth factor for your brain. It allows your brain to grow new neurons. It allows your brain to grow new cells. Doesn't matter how old you are, but BDNF is like fertilizer for the brain. Well, guess what produces the most BDNF, more than anything that we've seen, more than exercise. There's a lot of studies on BDNF and exercise, but guess what? Dry fasting gives you a surge of BDNF that will help you create new neurons and help you create new cells. And then the last piece, and I've talked about this a lot, why so many of you, whether you're aware of it or not, are intermittent fasting, is for what we call autophagy. Autophagy is where when you remove food from the equation, your body is so smart, just like it goes to search for fat cells for water, when you remove food and water from the equation, it will literally take the toxins inside the cells and your body will live off of those toxins and your body will self-regenerate. You are born in a miracle. Your body knows what it needs to do to heal. You just have to tap into some of these ancient healing strategies like dry fasting. So, dry fasting, I'm a huge fan. I'm doing it every Monday, some version of it for my own self. If you want more information on it, go in and put resetters. I'll invite you over. We'll get you into my group so you can see some of the people who are dry fasting over there. Now, how do you go about it? If you're hearing me for the first time and this sounds really exciting, I do not recommend you just jump into a dry fast. I think you should start with intermittent fasting and still do the fast training. But a lot of you guys are expert fasters. You've been following my work for a while. You've been doing the fast with me. It may be time to jump into a dry fast. My recommendation is anywhere from 12 to 24 hours. If you're gonna do a 24-hour dry fast, I really recommend you get coached. And the name of the game with dry fasting is if you get 5 hours into it, 3 hours into it, and you feel horrible, you are dying of thirst, you gotta stop the fast. So this is not a fast that you push on through. This is a fast you listen to your body. Okay, but dry fasting, super cool. I'm putting a blog post out on it. If you wanna receive my blogs and you're not getting them now, I send two amazing tips every week. I send a well-researched article and then I send you all the links to the articles, the videos, recipes, things that I'm working on and researching for the week. That comes out on Saturday. That's for my email list only. So if you want to be a part of that, just click the link below, opt in, I'll put you on my email list. I'm not trying to sell you anything, I'm trying to get you inspired about your own health and teach you things that will get your health moving in the right direction. So I hope that helps. If you've done dry fasting, put it in the comment section. I want to hear from you. This is cutting edge, this is new. A lot of people are branching out to try it. I want to hear your experience with it. Okay? Hope that helps. Have an awesome day.